Hello, I'm Slava at RethinkDB, and I'm excited to tell you about the 1.5 release. This release includes lots of exciting things, over 170 bug fixes, enhancements, and improvements. It includes performance improvements like write batching and soft durability. And one of the most exciting things, exciting features it has that I'm going to show you right now is secondary indices. So let's look at how you can use secondary indices in RethinkDB. So we've created a table here. My table, and if you're familiar with the web UI, you click on it, there is a new box here that says secondary indices, and that lets you create secondary indices visually just straight from your browser. So let's try to create an index on last name, for example. And boom, we've created it. We can now access records by last name efficiently. Now you can, of course, create secondary indices programmatically, so let me show you how you can do that. We have our DB demo and our table. And we're going to try to create a new index. We've already created one on last name. Let's try to create one on first name. OK, index is created, and let's list them. And now you can see we've got two indices, one created via the web UI and one created programmatically. Now, you can use secondary indices. It's very, very simple, and it's a very powerful feature. You can read more about them in the release announcement and the FAQ entry. We have lots of docs for it, API docs. So please check it out. It's a very exciting release.